All right, so today we're going to take this beautiful Les Paul that I finished in all my other videos and put a nice stain on it. I'm using these Keda dyes today, aniline-based stain dye. These are what supposedly Paul Reed Smith uses. So I'm not really familiar with these, never really used them before, and I wanted to do a test coat on this guitar first. So I started with the yellow, you know, just squirted a little of that powder into a small cup of water and just mixed it to see kind of what it looks like. So I started with the yellow here. I go with some brown. I was really surprised at how light this brown is. I added a decent amount of powder, but it's not really a dark brown. And then same thing with the red. You know, here I'm just kind of playing around with the red cherry burst to see what it looks like, because that's probably the most common colors that pop in flame maple. You can see I missed a little corner here on the bottom right, and just going back and forth and seeing how the colors pop in. And at this point, I really needed much darker colors for this body. So after that dried, I sanded it off with 400 grit. For some reason, that video didn't take. But here I go back and I add a darker brown. I add more brown into the water mix and begin to stain it all, and still very surprised at how light that brown is. Did the same thing with the red, added a little bit more red in just to see, you know, what kind of coloring I can get to pop. You can tell, you know, now that you've got that grain soaked in with the brown here, you get some really interesting figure. And essentially you just pop that figure in and dye it. This is actually the second darkening of brown, and it's just not as dark as I want. Really like the transfast dyes a little better because I can get a really, really dark coat. And here I'm just adding the colors to see how this looks. I'm going to dry this off. At this point, I've got a pretty interesting body. Definitely wanted to go for that slash look. I was playing with the red to see if I can get just some feathering. So what I decided to do then is sand off again, and here I've just got 400 grit sandpaper on a palm sander, you know, a hand sander, a foam hand sander, and just going back and forth and sanding off some of that coloring. Now what's nice is I'm pulling off the red because I really want to go for a brown and yellow base, but I've got that, you know, red highlight here, and I'm just going back and forth and sanding this off, keeping the paper clean, and just going back and forth with the 400 and just getting that first top layer off. And I don't use a power sander here because I don't want to recarve the top at all. I just want to use a hand sander and pull off that, you know, first piece of figure. These Keda dyes are water-based, so I'm using water-based dye here on this body, and that's why I stay with the 400 grit. I don't really need to get aggressive. I'm just kind of pulling off that top layer of fuzz. So here's how I actually mix the dye back in. I add more yellow here, and I just put the dye in those packets into these little squeeze-out bottles and just mix it in. Get a toothpick here and mix in the yellow into the water. And the more you add, the darker it'll be. And these colors say they'll mix a full gallon in those packets, but I really want a darker coloring. That's why I'm doing a little bit smaller volume of water. So then now that I've got the base sanded down, I'm gonna go with this darker yellow and begin to just rub it in. And you can see the figure really start to pop here. I've got the nice brown in all the different grooves and figure. I've got just a touch of red on the outside. Really getting that figure to pop. So if you look back at the beginning of the video when I had that first yellow, you can really see how much the guitar body is really popping with the brown bottom coat and the red on the outside. Getting some really neat coloring. So this process is definitely like painting with watercolors. It's a lot of back and forth trying to get the coloring right, and you're looking for any pieces that look weird, you know, if you get the color to sit too long at one spot, you'll get some blotching. So what you're really doing is just taking the water-based stain here and going back and forth. So with maple tops, sometimes they're hit or miss. I didn't think this top would look as good as it is. Right now I've got those big flames. Got a nice carve on this so you get a lot of depth in the figuring. And here I'm going to change the rag as I'm wiping in the yellow as I'm going back and forth because I really want a fresh coat of yellow on the top and I don't want to pull the red and the brown out. So I'm going to take my old brown rag and just highlight the edge. I want a little bit darker brown on the edge. Not looking for a full sunburst, but just want to accentuate the edge and highlight it a little bit. I don't want as much red in the guitar, so I could still see a little bit of red here as I go back and forth with the brown. Really just pulling out the brown and the yellow. And just having a slight bit of red that you can barely tell is there, but it's adding a ton of depth and coloring into the top. So next we'll speed this up a little bit. I'll do one more coat of brown and one more coat of yellow here at the end. And just make sure I pull all that red out. You can see there's a tad bit of red on the bottom and that last coat of brown just kind of peels it off. So next, after this dries, what I do is I take this razor blade and scrape off the binding where it got a little bit dirty with the stain. So you just take the razor blade and scrape off the edge anywhere where you have some of that color on the binding. You can use a scraper. I prefer the razor blade. You have a lot of control. And then here's the little corner where the neck joins the body. And you just take your time, go back and forth and scrape. You're really not pulling a whole lot of material off, you're just kind of cleaning it up. So we'll just speed that up. Then lastly, what I'm going to do here is I get a little bit of stick'em sandpaper. I'm just going to go over the edge where I scraped on the binding. If I don't do that, you get a really hard edge on that binding, and it's kind of sharp. So I take this little 220 grit sandpaper stick'em, actually I think this is 320 grit stick'em, and just roll this around the outside of the body on the binding and just make sure I don't have any sharp edges. That way it makes playability a little bit easier and makes the guitar just a tad more comfortable. So here's the guitar body after that last bit of stain. Still wet. You see the beautiful figuring on this. Just really outstanding. Really happy with the way this turned out. And then lastly here, I put a couple coats of sanding sealer on here. And the guitar body really does start to pop. This is just two coats, two light coats, and the guitar body really took to coloring well. The figure dances all over the place. In different lights, you could just see how neat the guitar body turned out. So we'll do a couple coats of nitro then on this, let it cure up, We'll have the finished guitar here posted in a couple weeks. Thanks for watching.